Γεια σας! Welcome back again to Do You Speak Greek and this 10 days challenge of learning the Greek language. Our first lesson is about pronunciation. We're talking about the Greek alphabet and how to pronounce the letters. Let's get started! First of all, we need to know that in Greek there are seven vowels. Alpha sounds like A in the word apple. For example, ανέμος, ανέμος. Then we have epsilon, sounds like E in the word elephant. For example, έλα, έλα. Next is ήττα, sounds like E in the word slim. Like the example, Ηρακλής, Ηρακλής. Another letter with a E sound is iota. For example, ιερέας, ιερέας. Next is omicron, sounds like O in the word lesson. For example, νερό, νερό. Ypsilon is one more E in the Greek language, like in the word slim. For example, ύστερα. Ύστερα. And finally we have omega, sounds again like O in the word onion, like ώρα, ώρα. So these were the simple vowels, but in Greek language there are also two-letter vowels. We call them δίψηφα. Epsilon iota and omicron iota sounds again like E in the word slim. For example, οικογένεια, οικογένεια. Κατοικία, κατοικία. Ειρήνη, ειρήνη. And κλείνω, κλείνω. Αλφα γιώτα sounds like E in the word pen. For example, παίζω, παίζω. Αίτηση. And γενναίος, γενναίος. Όμικρον ύψιλον sounds like ου in the word lure. For example, ουρανός, ουρανός. Χαλούμι, χαλούμι. As you understood, in Greek language there are five letters that sounds like E. Iota, ita, ypsilon, epsilon iota, omicron iota. And also we have two letters sounds like E, epsilon and alpha iota. And two letters sounds like O, omicron and omega. And now let's go to the consonants. First of all, vita sounds like V in the word vet. For example, vasi, vasi. Gamma sounds like Y in the word year when it's followed by E or E. For example, γεμίζω, γεμίζω. Or like γ when it's followed by α or ο. For example, μεγάλος, μεγάλος. Then δέλτα sounds like th in the word there. For example, δέμα, δέμα. Zeta sounds like z in the word zebra. For example, ζωή, ζωή. Now theta sounds like th again, but in the word think. For example, θάλασσα, θάλασσα. Kappa sounds like k in the word key when it's followed by sounds e or e. For example, κερί, κερί. but also, like K again, in the word lock, before a consonant or a sound other than E and E. For example, κόκκινο, κόκκινο. Καναπές, καναπές. Λάμδα sounds like L in the word light. For example, λάμπα, λάμπα. Μη sounds like M in the word mom. For example, μάμα, μάμα. And νη sounds like N in the word noun. Νερό, νερό. As for Ξ, sounds like KS or X in the word anxiety. For example, ξανά, ξανά. And P sounds like P in the word grandpa. For example, πέτρα, πέτρα. Ρο sounds like R in the word river. For example, σοβαρός, σοβαρός. And σίγμα sounds like C in the word city or S in the word serious. For example, σαράντα, σαράντα. Τ sounds like T in the word today. For example, τώρα, τώρα. And φ sounds like F in the word fat. For example, φορά, φορά. Φέτα, φέτα. Χ sounds like H in the word happy, after sounds like A, O, for example, χαρά, χαρά. Χορός, χορός. And also it's pronounced like CH, as in German ich, when it's followed by E or E sounds. For example, χέρι, χέρι. Όχι, όχι. Ψ sounds like PS in the word Pepsi. Example, ψάρι, ψάρι. So these are the single consonants, but also there are two letter consonants. First of all, we have B, sounds like B in the word baby, when a vowel follows or when it's in the beginning of the word. For example, babas, babas. Banana, banana. But also, it sounds like B when it's followed by a consonant or when it's in the middle of the word. For example, γαμπρός, γαμπρός. And then D sounds like D in the word dad when a vowel follows. For example, δίσιμο, δίσιμο. But also, like D when it's in the middle of the word. For example, έντεκα, έντεκα. Γου sounds like G in the word go when it's in the beginning of the word or when a vowel follows. For example, γαρίζω, γαρίζω. And also like γου when it's in the middle of the word. For example, ζούγκλα, ζούγκλα. There's also the combination γάμα-γάμα. It sounds like γου and the same, but it's used in different words and always in the middle of a word. For example, φεγγάρι, φεγγάρι. Τζου sounds like J in the word jar. For example, τζάμι, τζάμι. And τσου sounds like CH in the word cherry. For example, τσίρκο, τσίρκο. And now let's go to some other diphthongs. The following diphthongs are used in the beginning or in the middle of a word. I, I, oi, and oi. For example,
Νεράιδα. Νεράιδα.
Maybe you're thinking that this letter looks like alpha iota as an e sound, but they're different. You can recognize this diphthong because of the stress mark in the first vowel. So, when alpha iota sounds like e, the stress mark is always in the second vowel. When it sounds like I, it needs the stress mark always in the first vowel. And also there are the diphthongs iota alpha, ia, iota omicron, io, iota epsilon, ie, iota omicron, ypsilon, iu. The A sound of these diphthongs is pronounced like γου in the word γεμάτος. For example, παιδιού, παιδιού. Or like γου in the word όχι after μπου, ντου, βου, ζου, ρου, πού, του, φου, θου, σου. For example, ποιος. Ποιος. Two more vowel combinations are the letters alpha ypsilon and epsilon ypsilon. They're pronounced like af and f before gu, ku, ksu, pu, su, tu, fu and hu. Examples: αυτός, αυτός. Αυτοκίνητο, αυτοκίνητο. Ευχαριστώ, ευχαριστώ. And also they pronounce like av and ev before a vowel or before v, γου, δου, λου, μου, νου, ρου. Examples: αυγή, αυγή. Αυλή, αυλή. Now, let's talk about the final letters in Greek language. So, we have the final sigma and we use it only in the end of a word. For example, λόγος, λόγος. Μέθοδος, μέθοδος. And sometimes, we use the final νη in the ending of a word. So there are some words that sometimes keep the final ni and sometimes they drop it. These words are the feminine article tin, the word aftin, which means hair, and the small words min, then, which mean not. They keep the final ni when the following word starts from a vowel or from the consonants ku, pu, tu, bu. Do, go, ksu, psu. For example, tin, ida. Tin, ida. Tin, kopela. Tin, kopela. Tin, dulapa. Tin, dulapa. Δεν ξέρω. Δεν ξέρω. And one more thing we need to say in this lesson is about the accent mark. From the accent mark, in Greek words, we can understand the stressed syllable. The accent mark in Greek is written only in one of the three last syllables of a word. For example, Maria, Alexandros, Anatoly. One syllable words can't take an accent mark except from πώς, when it means how, and the word ή, which means or. When the stressed syllable is one of the two letters' vowels, alpha iota, omicron iota, epsilon iota, omicron ypsilon, alpha ypsilon, and epsilon ypsilon, then, as I told you before, the accent mark goes to the second letter. Examples: παίζω, παίζω. Είμαι, είμαι. If the accent mark is on the first letter, then the letters are pronounced separately. For example, ρολόι, ρολόι, Νεράιδα. Νεράιδα. I hope you liked this lesson. If you did, give a thumbs up and subscribe. And you'll find also in the description box any other information you need about the pronunciation in Greek and the letters. For tomorrow we have handwriting in Greek, so stay tuned. Γεια σας!